Welcome to this edition of Worldwide Hydro Headlines. I'm Gregory B. Poindexter, Associate Editor for Hydro Review and HRW Hydro Review Worldwide. Cost reductions in the Republic of Rwanda are a result of hydropower. Power from Rwanda's 28-megawatt Nyiragongo hydropower plant is expected to reduce the government's monthly expenditures for diesel fuel. According to Rwandan Infrastructure Minister James Musoni, costs for fossil fuel will be reduced from about $12.9 million each month down to around $7.4 million. Nyiragongo cost $110 million. It is a run-of-river scheme commissioned in November 2014 that increases electrical capacity to Rwanda's national grid by about 18%. In Eastern Europe, Slovakia is one step closer to receiving money from power generated at its 720-megawatt Gabčetkovo hydroelectric power plant. The Slovakian government is seeking nearly $350 million in compensation for profits it says Italian power company Enel made from the plant beginning in 2006. Now, the move by Slovakia came after the local Bratislava court invalidated the contract in place between Slovakia and Enel. In Scotland, CORMAT, an acronym for Contra-Rotating Marine Turbine, is a tidal energy buoy device shaped like an aircraft wing. Glasgow, Scotland-based Nautricity manufactures the CORMAT device, which houses a turbine unit that harnesses reliable energy from strong tidal currents. Nautricity has secured a grid-connected test berth at the European Marine Energy Center to test CORMAT units tethered by Nautricity's hydrobuoy mooring system. The system was developed using a $421 million Smart Scotland grant from Scottish Enterprises. What a fantastic day for a family of Tapulade tours around Portland, Oregon. I bet you there's gonna be at least 20 different kinds in the great Northwest. But the little buggers are not gonna bite me. I have my pesticide-free protection gear. Got my hat, my mosquito net, my camp coffee, and boom, boom, emergency chocolate.
Whoa, what is going on here?
What are you wearing?
Cassie Chitty, Michael Harris. Are you both ready to go on the Tapulade tours at Hydrovision International, July 14th through the 17th in Portland, Oregon?
What is a what?
No, not what is, you mean what are. Everyone knows the family of Tapulidae is a classification of crane flies. You know, the long-legged, like, flying insects that kind of look like enormous mosquitoes?
Gross. No, I don't want to go on that.
You're talking about the technical tours being offered during Hydrovision International 2015. Don't answer that.
Oh, man, no flies?
Oh my God, I really, really hope not. That's disgusting. No, at Hydrovision International this year, we have four technical tours that are going to be co-located with the event.
A technical tour is scheduled for the Merwin and Swift Dam projects on the Lewis River near... Oh wait, I get it now. Boom, boom. The Merwin and Swift Dam projects are near Mount St. Helens in the Cascade Mountain Range.
Okay, and the attendees also have the opportunity to join the tour of the Clackamas River Project, which features the longest operating fish ladder in the world.
And where hydro professionals can get an inside view of facility rehabilitation if they attend the Bonneville Lock and Dam Technical Tour. The Bonneville First Powerhouse, which contains 11 turbine generator units, is currently undergoing rehabilitation.
And finally, to attend the Willamette Falls Technical Tour, attendees must be registered for the Water Power Hydro Basics course.
Okay, so I'm wrong again, but tell me, where can people find out about these technical tours that are coming up?
Of course, just go to hydroevent.com and go to the technical tours page. They can find out all the information about all these technical tours and register from that page.
Well, that's it for this week's edition of the Worldwide Hydro Headlines, brought to you by Hydro Consulting and Maintenance Services. Make sure you check us out on Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter. And remember, we deliver hydro information at high capacity.